Thank you, Mr. Prabhu. The next speaker is S.R. Balasubramaniam. You're speaking next? Are you not speaking now? Okay. Okay. All right. A. Bijay Kumar. The next speaker is A. Bijay Kumar. Is in Lok Sabha?
Thank you, Chairman, sir. The bill seeks to provide a legal framework for bilateral netting of qualified financial contracts which are over the counter directory contracts. Netting refers to offsetting of all claims arising from dealings between two parties to determine a net amount payable or receivable from one party to another. The bill allows for enforcement of netting for qualified financial contractors. The qualified financial contractor means any bilateral contract notified as a QFC by the relevant authority. The authority can be RBI, SEBI, IRDA, PFRDA, IFSCA. The relevant authority may be notification designate an entity regulated by its qualified financial market participant to deal in QFC. This would include entities such as non-banking finance companies, NBFCs, insurance companies, and pension funds. The provisions of the bill will apply to QFC between two qualified financial market participants. This would be the include entities such as non-banking financial companies, The bill provides that netting of QFCs is enforceable by the contract has a netting agreement. Netting agreement is an agreement that provides for netting of amounts involving two or more QFCs. The netting agreement may be include a collateral arrangement. The collateral arrangement is a form of security provided for one or more QFCs in a netting agreement. It may include a pledge of assets or an arrangement of to transfer the little to a collateral or a third party guarantor. The inclusion of non-qualified financial contracts in a netting agreement will not invalidate the enforceability of netting of QFCs under the agreement. Close out this netting refers to a termination of all obligation arising out of relevant QFCs. The process may be initiated by a party to the QFC in the case of default, failure to honor the obligation of the QFC by the other party, or termination even as specified in the netting agreement that gives one or both parties the right to terminate transaction under the agreement. In case where one party to agreement is placed under the administration, the consent of such party or to the administration practitioner is not required. Administration refers to imposition of moratorium, proceedings of winding up, insolvency or bankruptcy. Among others, the administration practitioner is the entity, the administrators, the affairs of the party. The parties to a QFC must ensure that all obligations owned by the one party to other under the contract are replaced by a single net amount. The netting will have the effect of liquidating present and future obligation raising out of QFCs to which the netting agreement applies. The net amount payable receivable under the close out netting would be determined in accordance with the netting agreement entered to the by the parties if one exists, or through agreement between the parties, or through arbitration. Unless the agreement specifies otherwise, collateral provided under a collateral agreement may be liquidated without consent from the entity. The close-out netting is enforceable against an insolvent party and against the person providing collateral. If applicable, close-out netting is also enforceable against a party placed under administration, notwithstanding the any injunction, moratorium, insolvency, resolution, winding up or order of a court issued under any law. The administration practitioner cannot render effective any refer of cash, collateral or other interest made by connection with the netting agreement between the insolvent party and the non-insolvency party to a QFC. That's why my request, the central government can be notification, amend the list of authorities and acts which regulates the entities that are party to a QFC. Therefore, I'll support this bill. Thank you.
Thank you. The next speaker is V. Vijay Sai Reddy.